Welcome everybody to another Gaiscioch Community Summit. This is fall 2023. We have been going since 2001, actually fall 2001. We started back then on November 11th, 2020 or 2001 and have been going ever since. It's pretty much a very fun experience. Like, this has been a wild ride. I am your host, Foglotta, the founder and activities director for the Gaiscioch social gaming community. It's been a lot of fun so far. We do have some serious things to cover. We do have some fun things to cover. We got a little bit of everything. Be sure to type GSCH in the Twitch chat to enter today's raffle. We're going to be giving away a couple games, pretty much your choice, out of our loot vault. And yeah, I hope you all enjoy it. Let me know how I do. We're going to have a poll later and an AMA section later. So definitely stay tuned for that. First up, got a little bit of news. This month, we unfortunately lost another member, Jackie Lady Smith, who was one of our earliest members. She played Warhammer Online with us. She was a rune priest, kept me, Donna Liam, and Blockhead alive through all of our crazy shenanigans. Really hard person. Like, she would get on you and say, keep trying, keep doing this. And, like, we got through so many dungeons with her. It was so fun. But she did finally lose her battle to cancer. She leaves behind her husband and three young men. We are trying to help Blockhead out a little bit. He does need help with the memorial and the cremation and all that, the expenses that come with it. So if you have a few dollars to spend, please hit up that donate. You can go to gsch.info/q/Jackie. I created a quick link to get you over there, or you can just do the barcode scanner on that. She was a huge member of our community, served as an elder for several years while we were transitioning from Warhammer Online into Rift. A lot of you probably remember her, but very fun person to be around. In any case, on some less grave news, Gaiscioch is back in full swing. You guys have probably already started seeing it. There's a lot of membership coming back to the fold, getting involved in games. Summertime's over and kids are going back to school, and now we get our community back. So definitely check out the calendar, gsch.info/events. See what events are popping up. We got a whole lot of stuff planned for the fall into the winter season. Gonna be a good time. Next, I wanted to share a little something with you guys. If you're a fan of games, you are not going to want to miss this year's Extra Life charity event. We're going to be going for a, it's kind of a weird schedule. So we've got the last two weekends of October, we're going to be hosting basically a five-part stream both of those Sundays. So the last two Sundays of October. Definitely tune in for that. We got the best of indie games that first Sunday, and then the second Sunday is going to be the best of co-op. It's going to be a lot of fun stuff to show, and we're going to have a whole lot of raffle prizes. So you're going to be able to earn tickets for every single one of those streams that you watch. You go over to the gsch.info/extra-life. You make sure to log into your account if you already have one. If not, you can create one, and then you can simply click on the claim raffle ticket button during the stream, and that will allow you to start distributing your tickets to any grand prize you want. Going to be putting a call out to grand prizes this next week, and hopefully we'll get some good ones. We usually do. It's always a lot of fun. If you want to help the cause, you can go to gsch.info/eldonate. And contribute towards our goal of $5,000. That's what we've been trying to raise every year since 2011, I think. I think it was 2011 when we started this thing. This is our 13th year doing it. It's been a lot of fun. Every year we try to do a little something different. So this year I'm trying a few hype train weeks, get the little snowball rolling. Then on November 3rd, that's when the main event starts, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Three full days of streaming. It's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of things to show. In other news, guess what, guys? It's a bit late, but Conqueror's Blade is becoming Chapter 8. Yes, I made that rhyme. I tried hard. It was really, really hard to get that to rhyme. But this month, I sat down and started looking at things. I'm like, why have we never made Conqueror's Blade a chapter? Looking at the stats, since 2020, we have gained more members from Conqueror's Blade than any other chapter combined. In addition, 30% of those members that we got from Conqueror's Blade now play in our other chapters. Like, they're literally their activity is 30% in all of our games across the board. So I'm like, you know what? It might be time to look at turning it into a chapter. So I asked the elders, and the elders said, yeah, I don't know why not. We have had over 3,000 players come through our doors in Conqueror's Blade. That's a whole lot of people. So we had 400 of them register, as you know. Getting people to come to the website and register has always been a challenge. We continuously do so, trying to get more and more people doing it. I am working on the site and hopefully going to have it speed up a little bit more. Trying to find some of the pieces that slowed down, get things working as it should. And then, so Conqueror's Blade is actually becoming the very first time that we've had an adventure that has been launched, then turned into a chapter post-launch. Like, we've always had, like, adventure before it's launched, and then we chapter it as it launches. This is the first time it's kind of worked backwards, where it's been launched, and now we're turning into an adventure. In other news, this next couple months, I'm going to be kind of scaling back my events a little bit. I'm going to be kind of redistributing three of my days are getting reallocated, so the time that I normally would use hosting events. Sorry, I got the hiccups for some reason. But some of the events that I usually will run, I've canceled those for the next couple of months so that I could finish things like the trading post, the new lore system, getting some of the optimization done on the website. I need a little more development time, and I just don't have it when I'm running all these events. So I'm going to cut a few of my events to streamline that so that as we're rolling into the next real big kind of chapter, we'll have the infrastructure available to make it work all as it should. So, you know, we've gone over a decade focusing on single or two-game approach, and then we kind of shifted and started looking at allowing everybody in. So whether you're playing a small game with friends or you're playing the big game with everybody else, we wanted to basically embrace all of that. So we've explored a number of games like Guild Wars 2, ESO, World of Warcraft, New World, Conqueror's Blade. And now we're seeing that the Rift size chapter, for those of you that weren't around during Rift, we had 2,500 active players, a total of 4,000 people registered for our community to play Rift. 2,500 of those were active at one time. We used to crash the guild system just by pressing the letter G on your keyboard. So yeah, it was pretty extensive. So that size of chapter, I don't think we'll ever see again. In my honest opinion, I think the shift in how players play and how often people stick with one game has shifted drastically. Like nowadays, you'd be lucky to keep the same player in one game for 2 years straight. It's very rare that you see that. So I think that we're going to have to be a little more realistic and start bringing down that chapter threshold and be more agile as a community if we want to continue to survive. So smaller titles are enjoyable, but they're time consuming. So like these little things like Myth Force, I love Myth Force, but I don't see it becoming a chapter. You know, it's going to hold our attention for a couple months and then people are going to go find the next new thing. But we're just going to shift those little things with everyone. So as they're going along, they can still claim participation, they can still do things together. But that's kind of why I really want to kind of devote some time to our core system so that I can make our system more agile and not, cumbersome like it is now, and just overall streamline things. So eventually Guild Wars 3 will launch someday. You're right, Pedro. So yeah, that's what's going to happen over the next couple of months. So if you don't see me as often in games, that's why I am hard at work trying to build better stuff. So next up, let's take a look at the community. Right now, we have our eldership team with me at the head, community leader. Chapter 8, Conqueror's Blade, we have Donaliam, Izzy, and Pedro helping run the place. Chapter 7, New World, with Kiriel, Secoral, and Tip. Chapter 5, with Akirin and Sir Henry Vale. Chapter 4, with Guild Wars 2, we have Jilabod, Gmaw Fog, Kitty, Micah, Namri, and Olgoat. In our advisory board, we have Atrum, Clan Norton, Radiological, Soren, Vardr, Burga, Dargren, Rylissa, Terrifer, Chemical, Haggle, Smithy, and Tybor. Now, looking at our promotions this time, we've got a few Guardians. We got Boris, Burial Soup, Kaler, Sudu, and Zurata, all gaining their Guardian rank. Now, a whole bunch of veterans. And then we have our members. Those are the people that basically got to the Lord Gear rank. The members are who can start claiming or leadership for events. So as soon as you become a full member, you can start using the leadership system, claim your leadership, and then have your people that come join you for your events claim their fellowship. All right, and then our new members. There we are. Welcome to all of our new members. Do we have any first-timers out there? Go ahead and say hi in chat. I don't know if we have any first-time Gaiscioch members tuning into the stream. And if so, if this is your first community summit and you have never been here before and you came into our community this month, you are doing 100% better than every other member ever in the history of Gaiscioch because you're paying attention. So that's good. So congratulations. I know some of you may not want to speak, but it's good. Thank you for coming. All right. So Patreons, gotta give a shout out to these folks. These are the ones that kept this community alive when things were all dark and not looking good. So when 2020 happened and I had to lay off my team at my job and could take a half pay cut, if it wasn't for these people, Gaiscioch wouldn't have survived. They literally paid the bill for Gaiscioch and pushed us through. It just there's no way I could have supported it financially otherwise. So you gotta give a huge hats off to all of these fine folk. All right, so little Gaiscioch statistics for you. Right now, we currently have 437 total active members. These are people that are logging into our website and engaging in our community constantly. The numbers below for the top active game population by game, these are people who are logging into the website and interacting with the community. These aren't just people who logged into each game. So Chapter 4, Guild Wars 2, we have 356 active members. Conqueror's Blade, 43 active members. Palia, 23 active members. New World, 15 active members. And Baldur's Gate 3, surprisingly, 10 active members. Really kind of surprised at how well Baldur's Gate 3 is pulling as little adventure. All right, so let's go ahead and dive into some of our popular adventures. First up, Guild Wars 2.
I protected the world from the Cryptus for longer than you know. They bring everything to ruin. Welcome to the Astral War, Commander. Rifts are opening all over Tyria, beckoning horrors from the Demon Realm. That's where you come in.
Hi there, Commander. Been a while.
I
You've no idea what waits on the other side of the veil. No idea.
Guild Wars 2. Those of you that have been joining us, we've been having a lot of fun in the Secrets of the Obscure. We've been hosting an event every Friday that's been leading people through getting their Skyscale mount, pretty much taking it step by step, doing every little bit together. And we are pretty much, I think, about a week, maybe 2 weeks away from having it completed. Like, everybody that attended this event will have their Skyscale. So it's been a lot easier than it used to be. I have to say that the original guide that Gma Fog wrote about how to get their Skyscale, that was a little too much for me to do. Now this isn't too much for me to do. This has been really fairly easy so far. So we are definitely running events. If you have not seen it, there is more than 10 scheduled events on the calendar right now. I'm pretty sure it was 13 last I looked. And that will probably jump up to 15, maybe even 20 by the end of the month, because as people are returning from their summertime, more events pop up on the calendar. It's just kind of a phenomenon. Go figure. All right, so what's next?
Faith is our torch in a land shrouded by darkness. Devotion, our shield against heretics and sin. By the sword shall we bring justice and forge a path through the night. And if our swords be not enough, let righteous flames bring light.
Conqueror's Blade, this is a big one, guys. Season 17 finally brought in the kind of the Crusades era. Teutonic Knights are the theme this season. This is Season 17 Nightfall. As our community goes, we are returning to the old stomping ground down in the southern borderlands near the King's Valley area. We're focusing on upgrading that southern borderlands, trying to get the siege weapons up, getting the unit kits up. We've been having a lot of fun so far. The first war was rather intense. The second war looked to be intense, and then through some strategic negotiations, we managed to ease the tensions and have a fairly smooth end of the first week. I am still running the War Report live stream, which has been very, very, very successful. A lot more successful than I could have ever imagined, and that has been a lot of fun. It's a lot of work, but it's totally worth it. You can go over to gsch.info/g/cb if you'd like to get involved. We'd love to have you. We have two clans there, Gaiscioch and Gaiscioch Dub. If you're a registered member of our community, I welcome you to register and join Gaiscioch Dub. That's where a lot of our registered members are. In any case, let's go in and check out what's next.
Time. has no claim on the Eternal Isle. On human ambition. Nature must rise and reign.
Mighty lords, let us cleanse these lands.
But the future is fixed. For neither man nor beast.
End them.
Change is coming. For us all.
Alright, so we got a new expansion coming to New World. It is called The Angry Earth, I believe. Yep, and we're going to have a whole lot of content coming with that. The zone that was remove called First Light is coming back in a whole new form. That's going to be one of the major center focused events there. For our events that I've been running there, my Mondays at 4 p.m. is going to still be the Lootapalooza, where we're out hunting for treasures. On Thursday, I'm going to be doing an expedition blitz. We're going to form up teams of four and go diving into as many expeditions as we can based on which expeditions various players need. So we're going to try to put together teams to try to clear some of these ones that are kind of quest blockers, like you can't progress in your story if you don't clear these. We're going to put together teams and go run them together. So it should be a lot of fun. In any case, let's go ahead and check out what's next.
I have seen all that ever was, and all that ever will be. I have seen betrayal, endurance, ambition, and courage. I am the one who knows. Disconnected from fate's flow. Unseen forces move against me, hungry for forbidden knowledge. A mystery long kept hidden. A secret that threatens to unravel reality itself.
Online. Now, if you've read the newsletters, you probably know that we are going to be stepping back and taking a little more casual approach over the next month. I will be transitioning from a rigid chapter structure. Jeez, I can talk, I swear. To a more relaxed structure in the game, we're going to basically reduce the ranks that we currently have in game to 5, and then make it so that people have better permissions. So, like, in the chapter structure, we had everything locked down so certain people couldn't do certain things. We're going to open it up and let people do more things with the few ranks that we have and make a little less maintenance required to keep it going. We're not going to assign people to go play Elder Scrolls. So, like, in a chapter, we try to assign an elder who their sole job is to go play a game with people. Right now, we're not getting the people that we had assigned over there weren't getting the attendees to even warrant it. So we decided that we just need to step back with that. And if they want to play, we encourage them to play. But we're not going to continue trying to force people to play so that they end up hosting events alone. So it's just kind of the way it is. We're hoping Elder Scrolls does bounce back. But right now, we're not getting a whole lot of interaction from the community out there. You know, looking at the website statistics, we had 4 people in 3 months log into the website and look at the ESO page. That was myself and Henry included. So they're just not interacting with the community the way that we want to be called a chapter. So if you want to play ESO, we'll get you in. We welcome you to play it. We'd love for you to start attending some of Sir Henry's events. He's running events all the time out there and really wants to play with people. It's just people just kind of want to play alone. All right, so let's push on to the next one. Palia is a new game that just released. It's an MMORPG that is based on being a cozy adventure. It's actually our first cozy adventure that we've ever launched here in Gaiscioch. And it is all about banding together, building farms and crops and fishing and exploring and farming together. There are trees and rocks in the world that you got to grab friends and have you all whack on it to be able to farm it. Otherwise, it regenerates its health so fast that you can't possibly defeat it. So it's a whole new perspective on gaming. It's not like you go out there and fight giant creatures. It's literally you're fighting the elements. And definitely an interesting one. Right now we have Gmonfog, Kitty, Jerome, Micah, and Atram all playing it. Feel free to hit up any of them if you want to get involved. You can go over to gsch.info/g/palia if you'd like to check out the adventure. It is actually doing rather well. So there are cake parties, yes. So it's definitely an interesting one. I have not played a whole lot of it. I'm going to jump into it for the extra life, but in all honesty, there's not enough pitchforks and projectiles and fireballs for me. So it's not my kind of game, but people do enjoy it. And it's actually our, I think, fourth most played game right now. It's either third or fourth. Fourth. Yeah, it's our fourth most played game right now. So definitely get out there and have some fun with it. All right, so next in the list.
I saved you. And I'm here to save you again. The parasites are merely a symptom of a greater sickness in Faerun. The infected hear the voice of the Absolute and believe it to be a god.
The Absolute is more dangerous than you can possibly conceive. It threatens all who live. It threatens the gods, the weave, the very fabric of the universe itself.
How would you feel about helping me kill some evil bastards?
Lakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive.
I'll enjoy watching you try. In mere moments, all that you have dreaded will come to pass. When the screaming stops and your mind is gone, the rest, perhaps, is silence.
All right, so Baldur's Gate 3. This is a game that we knew was going to be good. Like, I had been playing it for several years beforehand in the betas. I crowdfunded it. It was definitely a game that I knew was something special. And I am throwing this out there right now. Come the Game of the Year Awards at the end of this year, I guarantee you this game is going to win it. I know some people are like, Starfield, but I believe in all my heart and all my soul that this game is going to win it. The reason I say that is because every single time I've played this game, things have been a little different. I have never gotten the same story. I've never gotten the same playthrough. It's always been a different experience, even when I try to play it the exact same way. There are so many variables, so many different things, so many different endings, so many different paths. You can try your hardest and still not end up in the same direction. This gives me some serious vibes of the old, like, Divinity Original Sin, the Icewind Dale. I loved Icewind Dale. This makes me kind of think of those days. So if you are a Dungeons & Dragons fan and want to step into a totally immersive world, this is it. gsch.info/g/bg3. We have a whole slew of people playing this game right now. And a lot of them want to play co-op. So if you want to get your co-op on, please connect with people. We have a whole Discord channel available to it. Hit people up in there. Start playing together. It's a lot of fun. It's even funner with friends, let me tell you. Seeing Pedro get murdered by a statue falling from the sky, that was amazing. I didn't mean to point you out there, Jerome. Didn't mean to point you out there. But yeah, so let's see what's coming up next.
Our story is more than what hobbits and elves know. It is time we told it ourselves. With hammer and axe, we mine and scout. Across Middle-earth, delving for riches. Yet the greatest treasure remains out of our reach. Moria. Fellow dwarves, rally together. It's time we took back our home.
All right, everybody, I got some good news about the return to Moria. It is releasing on October 24th, and Gaiscioch will have a private server for it. I've been told that there's going to be private service for this, and I personally am going to get us one. So we are going to have one. I'm going to lease it for 3 months. If we have people constantly playing and wanting to keep playing, we are going to have it. We're going to be rolling with it. It looks like a ton of fun. From the things I've seen about the game, the playthrough stuff with developers, everything looks fantastic for this game. It's a mix of a survival game plus Deep Rock Galactic. So you mix Valheim with Deep Rock Galactic, and this is what you get. There's some base defense stuff going on here. There's treasure hunting, exploring, digging, blowing things up. You can have your feminine dwarves with beards. You know, it looking like a lot of fun. So gsch.info/g/RTM. Sorry. I should have used a better font for that one. I'm sorry, guys. That's RTM for Return to Moria. All right. So let's see what else we have coming up. Synced is a game that you can play right now for free over on Steam. It is both PvE and PvP. There are PvP stuff to do. There is PvE stuff to do. You can play the entire game with it, never even setting foot in PvP if you wanted to. It is a co-op looter shooter, much in the vein of Division or, I guess, Outriders, some of those. It's a lot of fun from what I played so far. So we decided that we're going to give this a little run on the Extra Life charity event. We're also going to be streaming it next Sunday at 11 a.m. if you want to check it out then. It has been a lot of fun so far. I know Harkonnis has played quite a bit. Pedro's played quite a bit. It's the best price, as Micah has pointed out. It's free. This game is kind of one of those that jumped up and snuck out on us. I knew of it for a long time. But for the longest time, they only promoted the PvP side, so I had no idea that there was co-op even in this game. So when it was released free on Steam and the co-op tag showed up there, I downloaded it and tried it out and said, what's the co-op about? Lo and behold, there's a whole entire half of this game that's all co-op. Like, no PvP required. I had no idea that there was that much content that is all co-op in this game. So, if you're into co-op shooters, this is definitely one to check out, and it's the best price of all. Let's go and see what's coming up.
The vampire lord Daedalus ravages the lands of Eldrith. Brave champions band together to face the monstrous horde. Their team known as...
The heroes of Mythforce take the battle back to the Cursed Lands, where they face legions of deadly monsters. In the ever-changing dungeons of the Thicket and Crypts, the savage Beastor and the insidious Hexstar defend their malevolent master in his castle of evil. Against such fearsome foes, even the mightiest heroes might fall. But if at first you don't succeed, try again. Upgrade your weapons and power up your heroes, both inside the dungeon and out. Battle across 9 episodes inspired by 80s cartoons, fighting vicious enemies and their deadly masters. Play solo or with friends in the roguelike of the century. The 20th century. Available now.
All right. So, MythForce, it's literally the game the 80s called and want their Saturday morning cartoon back. Let me tell you. We played it this morning, in fact, and we had a blast. Pedro and Don and I, it was quite fun. If you like PvE co-op shooters, this is a kind of a melee brawler slash you do have some range weapons, but it has been just fast and frantic and just a great old time. So there's a whole wealth of diversity in there. The trailer is a bit rough to watch because they threw all the 80s filmmaking grain on it and everything. The actual game does not look like that. It plays a lot cleaner. And plus, I don't know why, but my internet bandwidth is being weird today. So the resolution isn't too great. It should be a lot better than it is. But I don't know. Could be the weather. Who knows? Let's go ahead and check out what's coming up down the road here.
We must follow the will of the ancestors. Accept your calling, descendant.
The descendants are risking their lives for us, for Albion.
Rise, my warriors! Give your lives for Klipoth!
It's the Ironheart! This could wipe out all of the Volgus, right? That's so cool!
Countless descendants have shed blood to protect the sanctity of this great place. Despite their efforts, humanity is still at risk of extinction. And you are the only chance we have.
So the crossplay beta ends tomorrow, actually, and I've had the chance to play all of once. I can't tell you, of the one PlayStation I did have, I was thoroughly impressed with it. I did not expect it to be as good as it was. Our community also has been very impressed with it. I had no idea that this was going to be such a great game. It's co-op. There's a lot of fast and frantic action going on in it. And I think we're going to have a pretty healthy group of people playing this out the gate. So when this one does launch, be sure to join our adventure over at gsch.info/g/tfd. If you'd like to get involved, I suspect we'll probably have about 20 people playing it at launch. It'd be great to be able to play it with friends. So I'll see you there. Should be a lot of fun. Alright, so the game formerly known as Star Keepers has taken on a new look, a new name, new everything. We have been working with their development team to try to help them, tutor them a little bit on building community systems, and hoping to have a little influence in on this one. So if you want to get involved in Alpha, you really want to reach out to me. So please reach out to me. Go to their website. And you can learn more by going to gsch.info/play/hh. That'll jump you over to their website. Register for the beta. And then contact me with the email address you registered with. And I will put you in the hat. So we are definitely working with the team to try to improve this one as best that we can. And it should be a lot of fun. It is definitely taking a new look and a new angle that they were originally kind of playing him and hawing on, but they decided to go for it. So they're going for it, and we're going to try to help them make the best game possible. So feel free to reach out if you want to be part of that.
Another fine day ruined by tyranny. But don't weep, rejoice. Come and see fearless heroes challenging the monsters of steel, channeling the good people's rage against our enemy. For their eyes were not made for crying, and there's no foe to resist their aim. Horror to make them blink away. No machine to beat their pulsing heart. And when the time has come to fight fire with fire. Of thieves to retrieve our stolen land.
All right, so Gangs of Sherwood is going to be releasing here right about the time that our Extra Life event is kicking off. We are going to be bringing that one into our Extra Life this year. It launches on October 19th. It is a co-op up to 4-player action RPG, and we're going to be giving it a go. Even if I have to play it solo, we're going to be showing it. So gsch.info/g/gos. If you'd like to give it a try with me, really think it'd be a lot of fun to play it with some of you guys. Everything I've seen gameplay wise is very cool looking, so it should be a lot of fun. In any case, I'm going to keep on going. We got a few more here, just a couple more. We're almost done, folks. Alright, so Steam Next Fest is coming up. The demo for this game, Enshrouded, is going to be available on that. You definitely want to check it out when you get your chance. October 9th is when it's going to be released on demo. Try out the demo. Let me know what you think. I want to hear all of your feedback. This is going to be a really fun game, I think. So it's a little bit like Valheim, except a whole lot more action-focused, a lot more fighting stuff, exploring stuff, doing puzzles. A little less chopping down trees. So gsch.info/g/ensh. If you'd like to follow the adventure for Enshrouded, we'll definitely be giving it a look. I'm hoping that we might even rent a server for this one too, so we can have our own private place to play. Alright, so now on to some distant things that are coming down the pipeline that I think you guys are going to enjoy.
Our guiding star has shattered. Shards scattered across the world. An ancient evil searches for these lost fragments. destroying anything in their path. You must find them. Harness their power. And put down this threat once and for all.
Questions I get asked most is, Fog, what do you think the next chapter is going to be? Well, you're looking at it right here. In all honesty, looking at the features it has lined up, looking at how they're embracing the guild systems, they're seeing that social is a big part of the MMO experience. They're trying to embrace that social aspect of the game. There's PvP, there's PvE, there's siege warfare, there's nothing forced on you, so you're not going to have to PvP if you don't want to. You don't have to PvE if you don't want to. There's ways to do about it. It's very much like if Guild Wars 2 was created again today. This is a lot of how it would play. So I have a lot of hopes for this. We're going to see how well the community embraces it. They may love it, they may not. Either way, we are going to definitely roll in expecting it to go chapter. Not sure if it will, but we'll find out. If we get 200 people wanting to play this, we certainly will throw a chapter label on it and make it a grand adventure there. They did send it back to the drawing board after the most recent test feedback. People hated the autoplay, and they've removed the autoplay from the game since then. They are definitely listening to the audience, which is a good thing. It's a very good thing that they're listening to the people and following the data rather than just the few vocal minorities. So they're reading their surveys and actually getting some good feedback on it. So we are very hopeful for how this is going to turn out. In any case, let's go ahead and look at the next one on the horizon. Thank you. All right, now I don't know if Taurus Land is going to be good. It could be. Closed beta number 2 approaches this November. I'm hoping to get in so I can take a look and see if it's any good. It is. There's a lot of question marks here, whether it's going to be, you know, too mobile friendly. Like, so it does have a mobile version, but that's supposed to be like built exclusively for mobile, and then the PC version is supposed to be built exclusively for PC. Not sure how it's going to play and how that's all going to work. We have seen a lot of games, you know, take off and seem to do well. This one has been doing really well over in the East. A lot of traction over there. Not sure how well it's going to be received here in the West. Really don't know. I mean, we've seen some games come out like Estelia, Bless Online, Elyon, Echo of Soul, Swords of Legend Online. They all look beautiful, but as soon as it hit the ground, it just like fell through the floor. So we're really going to have to see this one land and see what comes of it. It could turn out to be a great game. We won't know until we try it. So we're definitely going to be keeping an eye on it. So hopefully this November I'll have some more information for you.
My torch is yours. Light the way.
Rivers give trees their light. Trees that seize fairy sight.
Need to take a moment and go check this out. I mean, seriously, take a moment and check it out. There is a much longer trailer available that basically showcases pretty much one of the first boss fights of the game. And I have to say, I will be honest with all of you people. There's 25 people watching live right now, and I'll be honest with you. When I saw the closing scene of that first, like, boss fight, I kind of got choked up a little bit. I mean, literally, it was a little heartbreaking and like, it really kicks you in the feels. I mean, I've never had that happen in a video game before. Nothing kicks me in the feels like that. I mean, that one game, the Plague's Tale, that one kind of did too. But, like, there's a lot of story imbued into this game. And being it's apparently an MMORPG, I'm not sure how that's all going to play out. I'm really confused by the whole situation, but I'm absolutely fascinated with the art style, the music direction, the gameplay. Like the video gameplay that we saw was just phenomenal. It's kind of a Dark Souls like combat system, and is very narrative driven, so I'm not sure how the multiplayer aspect will even play into this, but any way we look at it, I'm going to be playing this. If you guys want to play with me, I'd love to play with you. It looks absolutely fantastic. I don't know how it's going to play, or, you know, if we're going to be able to group up and do dungeons, or if it's even going to be the same type of game that we're all expecting when we hear MMO. Don't know. But we're going to keep an eye on it and keep reporting when we see new stuff about it. It is definitely worth watching all the videos you can find on it, because it is a fascinating game, to say the least. All right, last one on the lineup. Here we go.
The Feywilds await, and so too Nightingale. Awaken your first portal and tread on towards that which is boundless, beyond the measurable. Sequestered, struck by woe and lacking supplies, the question becomes, wilt thou be a survivor? Regardless of which portal variety you favor, Realm cards will be necessary.
Folks, Nightingale is coming out into Early Access on February 22nd. This is another game that I will most likely have as a private server for, at least for the three-month period, see how many people want to keep playing it. It is a gas lamp fantasy co-op adventure. This is going to be a lot of fun. I really like the art style. I think the Victorian era was my favorite in all the fashion world. That was probably my favorite. I can't think of another period that was better. So if you want to play this with us, gsch.info/g/ng. Go ahead and join that adventure. Follow along, and I will be sure to report all the tidbits of news I can to you. We do have a little area in Discord for it as well, as we do for most of these games that I showed today. Our watch list definitely extends beyond the few trailers that I showed you. Here's our full watch list that I'm currently watching right now. These are all games that I am reading news on, watching daily, tracking new videos, and posting anything I find over in our Discord. So if you want to follow along any of these games, feel free to jump into our Discord, activate the roles, and I will keep you in the know. So next, we're going to go ahead and do a few little polls here. Let's go ahead and give you a chance to head on over to http://etc.ch/JWFW. Everyone, go on over there. Hopefully you can get there quick enough. And additionally, while you are over in Twitch land, be sure to type in GSCH. Going to be raffling off something at the end of this little kind of segment right here. Going to raffle two games. I'm going to basically give you your pick of whatever you want in our loot vault. I'll communicate with you after the stream via Twitch, so be sure that you turn your Twitch messaging on. If people can't contact you, no way for me to message you. Alrighty. You guys ready for the raffle? Or the poll here? Alright, let's go ahead and give it a good start. Alright, which games are you currently playing with us? Cast your vote now. Let's see what we get. All right, got some numbers growing, getting there. All righty, let me type the URL in chat here as well, just for anyone. So there is no HTTPS on this poll site, sadly. They're still behind the times on that front. There we go. Alright, so Guild Wars 2 is the big one on campus. We got Conqueror's Blade in the number 2. Well, the others are tied up there for first, but we have no idea what those are. Palia is ahead of New World, and Elder Scrolls behind that. That's pretty much mimics exactly what we see on our website, in fact. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the next one. All right, which of the adventures that are currently available are you most interested in? Somebody liked all of them. Now, I kind of think it's unfair to put Baldur's Gate in the mix with these other two. Baldur's Gate for sure is that game of the year. But Mythforce definitely has its charm. Sync is a seriously fun game. They're all really good games. It's just Baldur's Gate is like on a whole nother level. It's not even playing fair. So All right, 22 votes. That looks like about what we're going to be stuck with. So Baldur's Gate 3 leading the pack, Synced in the number 2, and Myth Force in the number 3. All right, next up, which adventures are you most looking forward to? So we have the First Ascendant, Havenhold, Gangs of Sherwood, Lord of the Rings, Return to Moria, or Enshrouded. Let's get those same 22 people voting, 23 people if I'm lucky. There we go. Almost there. Two more? Do I have two more? All right. Looks like First Ascendant's leading the pack, tied with the Return to Moria, and Shrouded in that number 3 spot, Gangs of Sherwood number 4, and Havenhold number 5. There's the 33. All right, and for the last poll of the day, which of those future adventures are you most looking forward to? Pretty much have a feeling of how this would probably go, but I gotta see if my suspicions are correct. 24, 26, 27, 30, 3 more voters. Alright, looks like Throne of Liberty is leading the pack. Soulframe and Nightingale are tied. I think, honestly, those three right there are definitely games that will grab this community's attention. Tarrasque Land is really a giant question mark. I really don't know if it has what it takes to grab anyone's attention. We will have to watch it as it's nearing, and once I get hands-on and can tell you one way or another if it's going to be our style or not, it'll be really kind of a clear indicator whether that will sink or swim for us. All right, so next tidbit, I'm going to go ahead and do the raffle real quick. So if you have not typed GSCH yet and you want to win a free game, please type in GSCH. We have about 1,000 games in our loot vault, and I'm going to let you pick yours. All right, let's go ahead and roll the first one. See a few people that haven't entered that raffle. I know you want to. I don't care if you're a Gaiscioch member or not. If you're a stranger out there and you want to win a free game, you let me know. You just type in GSCH. Short for Gaiscioch. All right, let's go ahead and roll the first one. Congratulations to Helic. Aren't you glad you just typed GSCH? Like, literally, you're the most recent person to type it. Congratulations, Helic. I will shoot you a code after the stream. I'm going to try a PM you right now, just to make sure I can. All right, and let's go ahead and roll that second one. Congratulations to Zerata. You are our other winner. All right, now I am going to jump over into Discord. We are going to want you to mute the stream now. Join me in the Discord channel that is labeled Community Summit. And we will be doing a little AMA. Hello, everybody, and welcome. If you hear me twice, be sure to go over to Twitch and mute your stream. Otherwise, it's going to be really hard to understand what I'm saying as I'm talking twice. Once now, and once in about 15 seconds. If this year is your first time in a Q&A session, there is a little button down at the bottom that will allow you to raise your hand. We will then be able to call on you, and you'll step up on the stage and be able to speak. You won't be able to speak until somebody calls in or somebody puts you up on the stage. I posted the link in the Twitch chat for anyone that's out there that doesn't have the link. All right, so any questions about the community, about the games that we're looking at, If anyone has any questions at all, feel free to ask them. There are no stupid questions, only stupid answers. All right? So don't feel bad. If you don't want to speak and you don't want your voice being broadcast, just type your question, and I'll do my best to call on your question, read it out, and then answer it. First up will be Pedro.
Hello.
Welcome, Pedro.
So in the previous community summits, we seem to have more games showcased than on this one. What's the reason that we have less games featured?
I'm pretty sure it's actually we had more games this showcase than we did last showcase. Because I added 3 slides.
Seems like we talk about other games that we didn't talk about in this one.
Yeah, there were some. We had several games that our community rolled into, and they faded away rather quickly. And they're not even being played. No events are being scheduled, stuff like that. We're only reporting on the stuff that is active.
Okay.
Do you have a game in particular?
A lot of people were looking forward to Ashes, and I know last time we talked about Ashes.
We've been talking for Ashes for about 6 years.
Right.
And that road has not changed. Like, Ashes is still on our forecast. It is still something that we're watching, but I have not seen anything new news-wise that I felt was worthy of bringing to the table and showing you guys about. It's just more skins, more spend money on new packs to buy stuff that will be released someday. I've not seen anything substantial for it, and they're still hanging on to the forced PvP mentality. And right now, that doesn't seem like it's going to be the best option for us, even when it does come out, because there's a whole group of people in this community that don't want anything to do with forced PvP. So a game like Throne of Liberty has the potential to alleviate that, because they're not forcing people to PvP, whereas Ashes of Creation is going to force people to PvP, whether they like it or not.
All right, fair enough.
So when I get information that is useful to people, I will throw it back on there, but I just don't want to keep reporting it over and over and over again like I have been for pretty much 6 straight years and not have anything new to report. This thing's already long enough.
All right, thanks for the answer.
No problem. Thank you for stepping up. All right, do we have any other questions? I'm watching for the Twitch chat. I did see Arc Raiders mentioned. Yeah, Arc Raiders kind of fell way off our list. It was a very high interest level, and then they announced that it was going to be an extraction shooter, much like the current wave of extraction shooters that are critically failing. So there's this thing that I've actually learned in my classes recently. I re-enrolled at MIT and started taking some courses to learn about AI. And in the process, I also learned a bit about business. And one of the things that they have is that they basically have this whole hype cycle where a new idea will come out. It'll be overhyped. Everybody and their grandmother will jump on it. And then they find what is known as the pit of despair, where there are so many of them out there that they can't possibly sustain themselves, and the roof comes crumbling down. The looter shooter, you know, we saw it with the MMO market in the pretty much the mid-2000s. There was more MMOs than you could throw a stick at, and then everything fell out of it. All the money fell out of the industry. We saw it with the MOBAs. We saw it with the FPSs. We saw it with the Battle Royales. You'll see it over and over and over again. And now this extraction shooter type of game where you go and collect all this stuff, fight PvE mobs, PvP mobs, and then get out and have to get to a singular point to get out. Those games have been here for about probably 6 years. The cycle is one that was well known for it. It failed once already and then got relaunched as another version of itself. And it's back up. So it's going to be interesting to see how this shapes out and how long that new fad is going to be in. But I think with like Dark and Darker, things like that are going to start taking off, do really well. There's going to be a whole crop of these new games, and then that market's going to fall out, and we're going to see a whole lot of shuttered companies because of it. So just keep that in your inspection list. That is kind of why the Arc Raiders fell off, is that they decided to jump on that bandwagon and move away from the co-op gameplay that they were loved for. Alrighty. deck, Ariel. I know Dune is definitely on the forefront of everyone's mind. We will be watching it. I have not seen anything new. I was expecting hopefully something new during GamesCon or PAX West. Didn't see anything new on it. So we're just waiting to see what's coming up with it. Ashfall was a lot of fun. Like, I played it with Pedro and Sekarund, and we had a blast out there. I think Don even played it a little bit. It's definitely a sneaker. I think that's kind of like, if you like Fallout, it's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to wait and see how it turns out. Next time that the beta's up, we'll definitely be trying to get a crew going in there. We got a guild open this time. Didn't really get to explore it much because we didn't have enough time. But we're hoping next time we'll be able to explore it a little bit more and get some things going. See how well it could embrace our community. Alright, I'm looking around, making sure I didn't miss anything. Camelot is still Camelot. I don't even know what to say, Wolvane. It's been over a decade, and the game hasn't changed one bit, in my opinion. Like, it's still the same screenshots, the same videos, the same news over and over and over again, and I'm not seeing any progress. I don't know that we'll ever see it, my friend. Anytime a game's been in development that long and still doesn't have anything to show for it, it's not a good sign. Alright, so for Havenhold, we have several of us that will be in that test. We will be rolling there. We work very closely with the devs. We're in constant contact with them on Discord. And we have been working with them for almost, probably say, 9 months now. We don't know if it's going to be, you know, an adventure or a chapter or anything like that. But Havenhold is definitely something that we're going to help. And, you know, just like any company, when a company comes to us and asks if we would help them with their game, we're going to do whatever we can to make that the best game possible. That's just the way that we are. Same things with Kingdoms of Aerloth. A couple of us have access to that test, and we're going to be helping out over there. And don't think that one's going to be a huge one for the Gaiscioch community. I think it's, if anything, it'll be Glory Victus-sized. It all depends on how that game ends up being. Like, it's still finding itself in the world. And if it becomes a PvP-only game, then it's probably not going to succeed as well as it would otherwise with our community. It may succeed with other communities, just not with ours. Yes, the Kinfall and Pax Day are both looking good. They are on our watch list, but we don't have any new information about them. Other than, I could say that I believe Kinfall is actually recruiting new testers. So if you're looking to test, you can definitely do that. Chrono Odyssey has nothing new since we last reported on it. Fractured Online is still Fractured Online. You can give it a try, be my guest, but I can tell you it ain't gonna succeed. That was the world's quickest flash fire with this community. Alright, do we have any other questions? I'm trying to watch three different chat sources, and I'm hoping I'm not missing anything. Wayfinder, we still have people playing Wayfinder. I'm not playing Wayfinder right now, just because I need the time to work on other projects. But there are still people playing Wayfinder. gsch.info/way, or it might be wayf. Or just go to our homepage and click on the Wayfinder area. EL. What do you mean by EL? Last Epoch, we have a group going to be playing that for the Extra Life event. Don't really have anything happening on our website. Like, I'm not seeing any traffic towards that adventure, but it is a phenomenal game. Yes, we have Last Epoch on Extra Life. We will be playing that for that. Harkonnis plays Epoch. But Harkonnis is also a streamer and has a lot of games on his docket, so getting time to play with him might be challenging. So definitely pencil some time off with Harkonnis if you want to play. And Dorda is going to be looking for people for another Blood Bowl season. So if you want to get involved with that, hook up with Dorda on our Discord. We'd love to help you out with that. Jerome's asking if I've considered if people want an adventure with My Time at Sandrock or Medieval Dynasty multiplayer. I have actually crowdfunded My Time at Sandrock. I'm still waiting for my copy to get here. But I don't know that it's going to take off well. I have Medieval Dynasty. I've played it quite a bit. But again, I don't know if anyone else wants to play it. You're always welcome to start up discussions. We have areas in our Discord where you can start discussing it. And if people start deciding to play it together, I will throw up an adventure for it. But I can't possibly create an entire adventure. You gotta realize, creating an adventure takes about an hour and a half of my time. I can't create an adventure for every single game that has multiplayer. I'm trying to create adventures around games that people are actively playing together. So if I just create them about every game, it's literally like we get thousands of adventures that nobody ever touches, and I really don't want to be wasting my time like that. Because I got to go hunt down art assets. You know, there's the background image, there's the logo, there's the icons, there's getting everything set up for the adventure side of things. It's a lot of work every time, and resizing them to all the different sizes that I need, setting up the Discord, setting up the bots for Discord, it's a lot of work. But yes, if you guys want to play something, there's a whole adventures area of our Discord. Ask in there if you want to play together. There are channels you can just jump in and it'll auto-create you a channel. You can then rename that channel to whatever game you want to play and get people playing with you. If people are playing it, then I'll create something for it. But I don't want to be creating stuff for something that nobody's playing. All right, let's see. Do we have any more hands? I don't see any more hands. Any other questions before we call this quits for the time? I'm hoping next summit I'll be able to have a lot more stuff for you and a little more juicy details on some of the internal stuff, like the trading posts I'm hoping to have done. I'm literally in the final stages of testing it, doing QA, making sure that it's not breakable. Pedro, we already had that discussion. Can't just keep resurrecting it. Do we see any interest or effort in reviving certain IRL aspects of the community, sports leagues, meetups, mentoring? Well, I'm still on lockdown personally. Like, I'm not around other people. The one time I did get jury duty, actually, was when I got COVID. I'm trying to protect my wife as best I can, and to do that, I've got to basically avoid human contact. And it sucks, but my wife's more important to me. So I love all of you guys, and I wish nothing more than to spend time with you all and just go to a pub or something, but I've got to protect my wife through and through. When your wife is not doing well and is immune compromised, you gotta put other things first. It's just how you got to do. But you're welcome to try to host get-togethers, whatever area you're in. There's more than enough of us. But someday I really would like to get together. And in fact, with our 25th year coming up, I am starting to look into potentially planning a group cruise. So I really wanted to see if we can potentially get a rate reduction through a friend of mine and get a group price for going to the Caribbean together. That could be a lot of fun. And by 2025, we should be over the worst of it, so I'm hoping that that'll be a better time frame. All right, guys. I haven't seen anything else. Looking forward to seeing you all next time. I want to thank you all for coming out. I will definitely be hitting up Zurata and Helek with your information. Get you guys choosing which game you want, and I will shoot you over the code. Thank you so much for tuning in. I look forward to seeing you guys all again soon. Have a good one, everyone, and I'll see you next.